Hey, it's Allison from Computers.Mom, and today's video will show you how to use a handy little app called Quick Assist for remote tech support. Quick Assist is an app made by Microsoft for Windows computers. It's free, it's easy to use, and the setup is pretty simple too. It allows one person, the helper, to remotely access the computer of someone who needs help, that's the sharer. This video will teach you how to use it, whether you're the helper or the sharer. And as usual, you'll find a quick recap of the steps at the end of the video for your convenience, so there's no need to take notes. Before we start, let's just be crystal clear that you should never, ever let someone access your computer remotely unless you know and trust them. Remote access tools are often used by scammers pretending to be legitimate tech support. Rule of thumb, if you wouldn't give the person your house keys, you shouldn't let them into your computer. Let's start with the requirements. Both the helper and the sharer will need a computer running Windows 10 or 11. If you're not sure if you're running Windows, it's pretty easy to tell. Your desktop should look something like this with a taskbar and a Windows Start button, normally at the bottom of the screen. If you're not sure which version of Windows you have, don't worry about it because either this will work or it won't. You're not going to hurt anything by trying. The second thing you'll both need, of course, is internet access. You can't connect unless you're both online. And you'll both need the Quick Assist app, which may already be on your computer, and if it's not, it's easy to add it. I'll show you how. You'll need a way to communicate, either phone or text or whatever works for you. And finally, the helper needs a Microsoft account. That's also free, but make sure you have your login information handy. Note that the sharer does not need a Microsoft account. When you're ready to start, both of you will need to open Quick Assist. Just click on the Windows Start button and begin typing the word quick. You shouldn't have to type more than three letters to see a list of suggestions. If you see the Quick Assist app, go ahead and select it. But if you search and you don't find it installed on your computer, it's easy to get from the Microsoft Store. Here's how. Just open the store from the taskbar if you see its icon like this. If you don't, open the Start menu again, search for the word store, and open the Microsoft Store. When the store window opens, search for Quick Assist. Select the Quick Assist app from the list and click Install. It can take a few moments to download and install on your computer. Once it's ready, you can click Open or Launch to start it, doesn't matter which. Now we see the Quick Assist window, and we can close the store window behind it. After a moment, you will see two options. Get Help, which is the option the sharer will need, and help someone, which is obviously for the helper. Let's begin with the helper steps. The helper selects the Help Someone button. They may then be asked to sign into a Microsoft account or to choose their account. In this case, the Microsoft account is already on this computer, so we just have to select it. Now we're ready to rock and roll. Quick Assist generates a security code and a 10-minute countdown begins for the sharer to join the session. The helper now gives the security code to the sharer by phone or text or however you're communicating. Be careful not to mix up zeros and O's or L's and 1's. If you read these zeros as O's, it won't work. But note that the code is not case sensitive. You can use small letters. Now the helper setup is done, let's flip to the sharer's view. The sharer has also started Quick Assist and then types the provided code in the box right here in the Get Help section, and click Submit. There's a brief pause while you get connected, and then the sharer sees a dialog box asking for permission to allow screen sharing. The sharer gives permission by selecting the button, and the screen sharing session begins. Let's zoom in on this dialog box, which tells you what's going on. Your screen is being shared. Now let's switch back to the helper side again. The helper can see the sharer's desktop in the Quick Assist window. If we make that window a little smaller, we can see a bit of the helper's desktop too behind it. So now the helper can see what's going on the sharer's computer and tell the sharer what to do, if you both have the patience for that. If not, the helper can click here to request control of the sharer's screen. When they do, on the sharer's side, the dialog box is now asking if they want to allow or deny the request for control. If the sharer clicks allow, the helper can now control the sharer's computer directly, almost as if they were sitting in front of it. When you're finished, either of you can stop the session by clicking Leave or closing the Quick Assist window. One important note, one thing the helper cannot see or control is a user account control window like this. If, for example, you're installing something and one of these pops up, only the sharer will be able to see it or respond to it, even when the helper has control. That's all there is to it. As promised, here's a quick recap of the steps to use Quick Assist for remote tech support. Both the helper and the sharer open Quick Assist by selecting the Windows Start button, typing QUI, and then choosing the Quick Assist app. The helper clicks Help Someone, signs in if needed with a Microsoft account, and then gives the code that appears to the sharer. The sharer types that code into the Get Help section, clicks Submit, and then Allow. Optionally, the helper requests screen control and the sharer allows it. Don't forget to close the Quick Assist window when you're done. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave us comments and questions. Click like if you found this helpful, and don't forget to subscribe for more Computers.Mom videos.